becoming 005, your mission, if you choose to accept it, is to identify any multiple of 5 within 5 seconds. Q will give you the intel.
The CIA agent
in Russia found out even multiples can be easily identified with a secret formula. Halve the number, place a zero on the end. As you know, our spies have found out that even numbers,
when multiplied by
5, end in a zero. Odd numbers, when multiplied by 5, end in a 5.
Coincidence? I think not!
Right, 005.
Let's see how this works. 5 times 6 equals. It tells us, halve the number. We get a 3. Because it's an even number, we add a zero on the end. Try another one. 5 times 8 equals. Aha, you say. Halve the 8 because it's an even number. Place a zero on the end. Try a harder one. 5 times 14 equals. Half of 14. You got it. 7. Put a zero on the end.
Try some
longer numbers. 5 times 22 equals. Half of 2 is 1. Half of 2 is 1. It's an even number. Put a 0 on the end. 5 times 48 equals. Half of 4 is 2. Half of 8 is 4. Put a 0 on the end. 5 times 264. Impossible, you say. Easy. Half of 2 is 1, half of 6 is 3, half of 4 is 2. Put a 0 on the end, we have our answer. These Russians are clever fellows.
What happens?
You say when the number in front is an odd number. Well, the clever agents discovered through espionage that they were able to solve this through partitioning into a 56 was a 50, and a 6 was a 6. Half of 50 was 25, half of 6 was 3. We added them together, gave us 28, and because the 6 made it an even number, we put on a 0 on the end. 5 times 56 equals 280.
Let's try a harder one.
5 times 1. 3, 2.
A half
of 100 is 50. A half of 30 is 15. And a half of 2 is 1. 50, oh, we can do that, 6. 666, it is an even number, I put a zero on the end. But what about odd numbers? Our spy in Russia sent us this microfilm. It tells us to look at the previous number, halve it, place a 5 at the end.
What does this look like?
5 times 7 equals. We know it's an odd number. The microfilm told us, look at the previous number, which is a 6. I'm going to halve it to get a 3, and because it's an odd number, I'm going to add a 5. Let's try a harder one. 5 times 15 equals. The previous number is 14. I halve it, I get a 7, and because it's an odd number, I'm going to add a 5.
5 times
21 equals. The previous number is 20. I'm going to halve it, I'm going to get a 10. I'm going to add a 5 on the end because it's an odd number. It's an odd number. I'm going to look at the previous number, 62. I'm going to halve it and I get 31. put a 5 on the end because it's an odd number.
Now let's apply
partitioning. 5 times 53 equals. It's an odd number. I look at the previous even number, 52. I know that partitioning is dividing this into a 50 and a 2. Half of 50 is 25. Half of 2 is 1. I get 26. Because it's an odd number, I'm going to add a 5. 5 times 175 equals. It's an odd number. I look at the previous even number. Now I can halve it. A half of 100 is 50. A half of 70 is 35. A half of 4 is 2.
7.
87. I know that it's an odd number and I put a 5 on the end.
Right.
005. Let's see if you're ready to go undercover. 5 times 6, 4, 4 equals. Have you identified whether it's odd or even? It's an even number. Well done. We halve it. Because it's an even number, we put a 0 on the end. Next one, 5 times 2.
8, 4,
1. Have you identified whether it's odd or even? It's an odd number because it ends in 1. We look at the previous even number, 2, 8, 4, 0. We now halve it. Half of 2 is 1, half of 8 is 4, half of 4 is 2, and half of 0 is 0, and we add our 5 on the end. Let's give you a really hard one, 005. 5 times 6, 2, 1, 2.
Equals. Is it an even or
odd number? You recognize that it's an even number. So we start halving it. Half of 6 is 3. Half of 2 is 1. Half of 1 I can't do. Put a 0 down. But now it becomes a 12. Half of 12 is 6. It's an even number. I put a 0 on the end. Yes, you are definitely ready. 005.
This message will self-destruct.